Hello and welcome to the Akeo Tech channel, where business and technology are two peas in a pod. My name is Louis Procopio, and today we're going to be talking about a very exciting open sourced blockchain project. It is dubbed the Blockchain for Business. It's modular, it's plug and play, it's Hyperledger Fabric. So here at Akeo, we don't just work with software development, we also work with something called concept development. We've worked with a lot of businesses with a lot of different business models and business structures. An important part of the concept development process would be knowing which technologies to use. Hyperledger Fabric is a permissioned blockchain and one of the many tools available to help businesses and existing systems increase efficiency or even do things that were once impossible. Today, I had the opportunity to sit down and have a Hyperledger chat with a coworker who knows a lot about the subject. I guess you can call him my first guest. Espen is the CEO of Akeo, and he's here today to talk a little bit about Hyperledger Fabric. We're seeing more and more that Hyperledger really has a good fit in the business world. What is it about the configuration, or what is it about Hyperledger Fabric that makes it a better fit than Ethereum, for example?
So the really short version is that for Ethereum, everything is public and everything is permissionless. Practical wise, that would say that all transactions can be seen by everyone.
Right.
So in most enterprise cases, you don't want that to happen. Let's say some basic stuff like, there's someone selling something and you have some customers. And maybe some customers have better price than other customers. Usually
there's different deals or different, right?
And you don't want them to see the data. I mean, you don't want customer one to see the data from customer two.
Right.
In Ethereum, there's nothing you can do. I mean, everything's is public.
Open. Right. Yeah.
But for Hyperledger, I mean, this is by design. This mm-hmm. is how it's made.
Right.
So you can actually split the ledger. Meaning that some participant can just see some of the ledger and you can set it up like this. So the configuration with the roles, how we can configure it, really makes it a extremely good stack for business cases. For each organization, and for simplicity, let's just say one organization is a company. They can run multiple pairs, it's called pairs, mm-hmm. like each installment. And the pairs, again, I'm not going to get too technical now, but the pairs can have different types of pairs as well. But we can leave that for another technical walkthrough.
Yep.
So just to say it very simple, one organization will keep their part of the ledger. They can share it with some part can be shared with other companies. So it's a perfect setup for having, for example, competitors working together on something like supply chains.
Right.
Going to be huge on Hyperledger. Because let's say shipping, like you have different companies actually being competitors,
mm-hmm.
but they can work together in a standardized way. And in Ethereum, this is called smart contracts.
Yeah.
On Hyperledger, we call it chain code. So you can write code which will, define how trust is enforced between these companies. Because blockchain is all about trust.
Right. Blockchains are distributed among nodes.
Yeah.
And I guess the difference between the Hyperledger blockchain and the Ethereum is that they're still in Hyperledger distributed among nodes. But can you talk a little bit about where decentralization is really up to those that are configuring the blockchain?
Hyperledger is in most setup less decentralized than Ethereum. But I would say it's as decentralized as it needs to be,
right?
To support the case or the business case you're using.
Right, and that's something that can always be configured according to whatever the needs.
Absolutely, and I mean according to budget. I mean you can just keep on speeding up nodes,
right,
and making it really big.
Mm-hmm.
But what's the meaning of it?
Right.
So there are a lot of use cases where Ethereum is a better fit, also for business-to-business applications.
Okay.
So it's back to what you said about concept development. This is what we do here.
Right.
We create concepts for people. So it's this is something that we look at in each business case. Blockchain is being pushed as like a solution that will fix all problems.
Right.
And in my opinion, or not opinion, this is more of a fact, blockchain is a tool to be used for some things.
Right.
And it's part of a bigger delivery, like standard ways of having a database, having business logic off-chain.
Mm-hmm.
In most cases, it makes sense to have that.
Yeah, you don't need it necessarily on the blockchain.
And in many cases, it will just make it harder and less user-friendly and you know, more work to maintain it. So it's very important for companies like us to not try to oversell the
mm-hmm.
concept of a blockchain.
Right.
In a lot of cases, it makes sense, but still, the technology is young. It's immature, and but in my opinion, we're seeing the start of something that will be really, really huge.
Right.
And for me, Hyperledger, supported by Linux Foundation, IBM is a big player here.
Mm-hmm.
This is for me the best enterprise blockchain we have today.
Awesome.
Yeah, it is.
All right. Well, thank you very much for being on the show today, Espen.
Thank you for having me.
Hopefully we'll talk to you soon again.
We will.
So blockchain is not an end-all problem solver. There is a need for a less decentralized and less transparent blockchain. And Hyperledger isn't necessarily the only option for your B2B business model. I hope you're learning something new with every episode. You may not feel like an expert, but I think that's okay. I'm no expert, and we're here together, learning together. Before I ask you to pretty please like and subscribe, here comes this week's critical thinking question. How can a Hyperledger Fabric blockchain be distributed among nodes, potentially spread across the globe, but still be classified as a centralized blockchain? Are those wheels turning? Do you think you know the answer? Don't be shy, comment below. Also, if you've heard anything today that you absolutely disagree with, then let's discuss it in the comment section. Are you interested in learning more about how blockchain is being used today and what problems businesses are trying to solve with this technology? Then head on over to akeo.tech, where you can download our free guide for business professionals. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week when we take a look at yet another stunning blockchain for business. It's also an open source project. It's supported by organizations like Amazon Web Services, Intel, and an army of banks. It's dubbed the Blockchain for Finance. It's Corda. See you next week. Bye-bye. Thank you for being here today.
Yeah.